And the reason that we use gear trains is in order to affect mechanical bend. So if we want more torque, we can get more torque using gears. If we want to get a speed reduction, we can also use gears. And vice versa, if we want to lower the torque and increase the speed, we can use gears. So that's why we use them. Right. The basic configuration is you have a pinion mating with a gear. The pinion is normally recognized as the smaller of the two things that are mating. And then you have the gear, which is the larger of the two. On this is called the pinion, and this is called the gear. Mm-hmm. So if we have something where we have this moving in this direction here, a positive direction, then the gear, so if the pinion's moving in a positive direction, the gear is moving in the opposite direction, which is negative. And this thing here is called the pinion pitch circle. And this here is the gear pitch circle. So when you are actually putting these things together, there are, that's the book. Someone have the book? Wait, can I borrow you one for a second? So this is really the if you look at gears, and you look at them in your junior design class, right?
Yep.
Sure, if you say so. All right, so if you look at all these things here, the addendum and the thedendum and the pitch radius for the pinion and the pitch radius of the gear, or even this right here, if you're looking at this, the base circle, the pitch circle, all of this stuff here, the addendum and the dedendum, the key diameter that you're looking for is the pitch circle. The pitch circle is really, the pitch circle of the pinion touches the pitch circle of the gear. Okay? So when I draw this and I draw them as touching, that means I'm drawing the pitch circles. And the ratio between the pitch circles gives you your gear ratio. Not the ratio between, well, actually, I think it would work between the base. But anyway, the key is that you're looking at the pitch circle. All right? And this right here is external meshing. But there's also internal meshing. So if you have something that looks like this, center here. is what they call the internal ring gear. This is internal meshing, external meshing. All right, and then we can draw this close circle here. Meant to be in the middle of that. And this would be your pinion. So in this case here, a positive motion here will produce a positive motion on the ring gear. That's the main difference between external meshing and internal meshing is one is as the pinion is being driven, the gear is being driven in the opposite direction on external meshing, and on internal, the pinion being driven in, say, the positive direction drives the internal gear in the negative or the positive direction. But this right here would have this arm fixed here in order to get this thing to move, okay? Normally what happens is the arm is moving, the pinion's moving, and the ring gear's moving.
So they're just moving in the same direction on
this one? On this one here, they're moving the same direction. All right, so let me re-emphasize that the pitch circles are where all analytical measurements are based. And gear teeth are used to prevent slipping. What I mean by that statement is that if I could magically get away with not using any gear teeth at all, that'd be great because gear teeth are complicated to make. So if I was magically able to get away by using no gear teeth at all and just using two cylinders that are kind of sticky, okay, that won't slip. As one rolls, the other one's going to roll, and there's going to be constant contact between them with no slipping. I'd do that, but in reality, that's not possible. Therefore, I use the gear teeth. But yet, the pitch circles are the things that determine how these things are moving relative to each other. So that's why we're just going to focus on those. Okay.
Is that arm mounted? Is that a ground?
Yeah, in this case here, I've drawn it so it's mounted to the ground. It's fixed. So gears are used for mechanical advantage. Via torque conversion and velocity conversion. So if we want to get more torque out of something, so if torque goes up, that means my velocity of whatever I'm driving goes down. And vice versa, I can actually get torque to go down and get my velocity to go up. But this is normally the thing that we're looking for right here, is we want to get an increase of torque and sacrifice velocity in order to get that torque, that increase in torque. A typical example is an engine in a car where your first gear has a tremendous amount of torque, but if the engine is spinning at, say, 1,000 RPMs, the back wheels are barely turning at like one revolution per minute, but there's a tremendous amount of torque. Alright, so that's the principle. Okay, let's go ahead and see how these pitch circles, when they're rolling relative to each other, how they're moving.